for the ballot boxes to vote in what could be the most crucial election the United Kingdom has ever seen. Conservative Prime Minister David Cameron looks to defend his four-year rule over the country against centre-left Labour opposition candidate Ed Miliband. The latest pre-election polls show the leaders of the UK's two major parties tied neck and neck at 33%, with neither party expected to attain a majority in the next parliament. Should the first-place party fall short of a 326-seat majority in the 650-seat parliament, a new coalition government will have to be formed. In the probable outcome of a coalition, smaller parties may fulfil the part of kingmaker in deciding the nature of the next government. The United Kingdom Independence Party, otherwise known as UKIP, is currently the UK's third most popular party and promises to play a key role in post-election coalition talks. Meanwhile, current coalition partner Liberal Democrats may add leverage to the new government despite being knocked down to fourth by UKIP. The stance of the Scottish National Party, or SNP, which has been predicted to win most of the 59 seats in Scotland, may also prove to be a decisive factor in the makeup of the next parliament. Current coalition partner Liberal Democrats seem likely to become the wildcard in the post-election talks. While ruling out joining any coalition that includes UKIP or the SNP, party leader Nick Clegg could face a revolt from party members if he decides to back the Conservatives again. As a pro-EU party, the Liberal Democrats have struggled to gel with David Cameron's Conservatives, which is calling for a referendum on the UK's EU membership. However, an alliance with the Labour Party is still unlikely to combine enough votes to reach a majority. The SNP has also indicated its willingness to ally itself with Labour, but Labour has expressed reluctance in joining forces with the secessionist party. In the lead-up to the polls, a war of words between UKIP and the SNP has highlighted major differences between the English and the Scots. UKIP leader Nigel Farage caused controversy after he accused SNP of being openly racist against the English. Farage also slammed the Barnett formula, which sees 20% per capita more public spending in Scotland than in England. Having organised a referendum for the independence of Scotland from the UK last September, in which 55.3% of Scots voted to remain in the UK, the SNP is suspected of seeking to enter the new government with the aim of splitting the country.